people understand from yesterday class itself. From yesterday class itself, if people understand what are the materials I am providing. Okay, those all things I have chance to show to you people, right? Now, apart from this OBW 11G and 10G, apart from this OBW 11G and 10G, and also I am providing BA Publisher 11G and 10G. Okay, BA Publisher also an integrated component. Previously, it was known as XML Publisher. Now it is called as BA Publisher. That also I am delivering. Now we are going for DAC 11G. It is the latest version in the market. Okay, that we are covering. And OBIA available in two flavors. 7964 is with the combination of Informatica and OBIWE. And 11117 is the combination of ODA plus OBIWE. Okay, we'll try to see both the things. What are the changes are there? And this analytics are divided into CRM analytics. Some of the examples for CRM analytics are like sales analytics, okay, service analytics, marketing analytics. These all things are called as CRM analytics. ERP analytics, financial analytics, HR analytics, okay, supply chain, order management analytics. These all things are examples for ERP. Industry analytics is, let's say, pharma analytics, telecom analytics. Okay, these all things are what, sir? Okay, industry analytics. So these things you are going to cover as part of the OBIA. Now, yes, we are also going to cover live project with live data. In fact, whatever I am going to explain, that itself is live, sir. Why? Because if you see my notes, designing my PPTs or my answers, those all things, I am not using what Oracle guy is using. Oracle guy normally used to use the data BA sample. BA sample is the data which he is going to use to explain his tool. But I am using a data that is supplied to data. Based on that only, I designed my total notes. So whatever we are going to do, that is going to as a one project only. Your course itself will go as one project. On top of that one, end of this one, we are also going to discuss one more project. Next, Informatica 9.5 basic level, ODA 11G and 12C basic level we are going to understand. So this was the RRI Tech training outline. Yesterday we have chance to discuss it. Am I clear? Now, as part of today's class, let us move on to the next one, Demo 2. I want to discuss OLTP versus OLTP. Before going for the Demo 2, who not came yesterday, those guys, anyone has any questions, please go ahead with your questions. Yesterday, I have chance to discuss these all points. I have chance to discuss with them. Okay, what is data, types of data, types of databases, DW architecture, OVA role in data warehousing, RRI Tech training standards. These are the points what I discussed yesterday. If you have any specific question on these topics, yes, you can raise your voice so that I can answer those things. If no, then I'll go with the demo two.
And Ramil, you have one question. I'm Kanan.
Yeah, go ahead.
Like real life projects, you mean to say, for example, CRM analytics, like
okay.
Hello. For live project, you will be sharing the OLTP database of CRM also, like those tables, SQL tables, how to extract data from those tables.
No, sir. No, not that level. We are working as a OBW tool. We are learning, right? So I'll give directly data warehouse tables to you.
Okay.
I won't.
Only table starts with W.
Yeah. If you go for the Informatica or ODA means, I will be giving the OLTP data to you. From that OLTP, you are maybe building the OLAP. But you are learning OBW, right? So I will give the directly OLAP data I will give to you. From this OLAP, we are going to build the reports.
Okay, fine.
Okay? Right.
Yeah.
Any other questions? If no, let us move on to the next one. I am moving on to the next one. Let me move on to the next one. As part of this demo 2, we are going to discuss mainly concentration is, you people understand from yesterday's class, we have two types of data. One is called as transactional data, second is called as analytical data. And transactional data we are storing in one database. The database is known as OLTP database. And analytical data we are storing in one database. The database is known as OLAP database. If suppose someone is asking a question, what are the more differences between OLTP and OLAP? you should be in a position to explain some more points about that, right? That is the reason this today's class is going to help you out. Today total class is going to drive based on the OLTP versus OLAP. OLTP versus OLAP. Right. First point, if you go and understand, is useful to store transactional data. Is useful to store transactional data. I hope this point is not a new point for you people. Yes or no? Yesterday itself, we have chance to discuss this one. OLTP is useful to store transactional data. Second one, is useful to run your business. Is useful to run the business. Now, third one, the nature of data is current and detailed. I hope these three points yesterday already I covered whenever I was discussing transactional data. When I was discussing transactional data, I discussed the current and detailed data. It is useful to run our business. And transactional data we are storing in one database that is known as OLTP database. That is known as OLTP database. Now, if you go and see these three points, the three points are commonly here also it is came. The three points commonly here also it is came. And opposite to these three points, we have here transactional data we are storing. Here we are storing what, sir? Analytical data. This is useful to run our business. This is useful to analyze our business. This is storing current and detailed data. Current opposite historical, detail opposite summarized. Detail opposite summarized. So these are the three points from yesterday points only I derived it. Now fourth point onwards, actually our learning is going to happen. Fourth point onwards, today learning is going to happen. Fourth point is OLTP supports CRUD or create partial reading, update, deleting. These are the functionalities it is going to support it. We can create a record in the database. We can read some of the record, that is partial reading. We can update the record. We can delete the record of the OLTP. Whereas OLAP records, we need to do only one activity. That activity is called as reading. Now, to understand more about this one, let us say I am going to the MS Office Excel. Okay. Now, we have here some vendors are available. Let us say Oracle is the one vendor. And IBM is the one vendor. And we have the Microsoft is the one vendor. Microsoft is the one vendor. Like these different vendors are available. Oracle is providing one database. The database is known as, what database is providing, sir? Oracle database is providing. IBM guy is providing one database. The database is what, sir? DB2 database is providing. This guy is providing one database. What is the database? SQL Server database is providing. Tell me, anyone is, while they're selling their database, they're saying like, my database is for the OLTP purpose or my database is for the OLAP purpose, like that anyone is selling, sir? No. Simply they are saying as, this is my database. This is my database. Use whatever way you want it. You want to use as a OLTP, use it. You want to utilize as a OLAP, use it. Based on what parameters we are going to design this one. Right. We are going to install the software. That day one, whenever we are installing, we are going to take care at the time of installation itself. Is it useful for the OLTP means we will install one way. If it is useful for OLAP means what, sir? We will install in another way. Suppose I will show you one simple database I will create and I will show you. Let us say I am going to the start, then all programs. There I have the Oracle. There I have the configuration and migration tools. There I have the database configuration assistant. If I am clicking on that one, then we are going to get one window. Shortly, I am going to get one window. I am waiting for that window. Yeah. Now we got this window. Welcome to database configuration assistant for Oracle database. What database it is? Oracle database. General it is. Oracle database. The database configuration assistant enables you to create what you can do, sir? You can create a database. You can create a database. And we can do what, sir? We can configure database. We can configure database. Okay, these two things are important for me. Click on next. Whenever I clicked on next, it's asking, you want to create the database? Yes, I want to create the database. Click on next. Then whenever you click on the next here, what purpose you are creating? This is very important for me. This is very important for me. What purpose you want to create, sir? General purpose. That means what, sir? To store the transaction. That means if you select this radio button, it is going to act as what, sir? OLTP. You are creating a database. The database is OLTP database you are creating. If you select this one, then we are going to create what type of database, sir? OLAP. That means that day whenever you are installing your database, that day only we are deciding, okay, my database is I am going to use down the line as OLTP. My database down the line I am going to use as what, sir? OLAP, that we are deciding at the time of installation. Okay, that's what I given here one point. The point is called as, at the time of installation itself, we are going to take care, is it for the OLTP or is it for the OLAP? Not only installation, if you go, once I selected the data warehouse, if you go for the next and all, it is going to give you some kind of configurations also. Let us say I am giving here ORCL 1, then click on next. Then I need to select here configuration enterprise manager, automatic management task. Then here I need to provide the passwords, everything. Then I need to configure some of the things. So what I would like to say is installation followed by what, sir? Followed by you need to do some kind of configuration also. That is okay. Now next very, very important one is installation and configuration is a one day activity. Yes or no, sir? That day one, whenever you're installing the software, that day we are going to select the general purpose or what, sir? Data warehouse purpose. General purpose means transactional database. Data warehouse purpose means analytical data purpose. And configuration also, according to that one, memories, everything, we are going to assign it. These two things are one-time activities. Once your database is ready, how we are going to use, that makes really more sense to the, it is a OLTP or OLAP. How we are going to use this database? We are going to use this database for the purpose of what? I am going to use this database for the purpose of, let us say, running. For the purpose of analyzing my business. So a database you can use for the purpose of running or you can use for the purpose of analyzing. If you want to run your business, what are the activities you need to do? Let us say you have one bank, that bank is known as JP Morgan Bank is available. Now, if you want to run your business of the JP Morgan, what are the activities you need to do? Let us say one new customer came and said like, sir, I want to open one account in our bank. Just I traveled from India to USA. So I don't have in India, there is no JP Morgan bank is not available. So I don't have the JP Morgan account. But in USA, most of the transactions are happening using JP Morgan. So I want to open the account. So they should be collecting all the details to you from you. Okay, what is your social security number? What is your passport? Those all things you may be collecting. Then he is going to provide one account number to you. Yes or no, sir? Now tell me, this account number they are providing means they are creating one record in the table of the active customers or not, sir? They are creating one record in the table of the active customers table. So what I would like to say is, our database should be supporting one thing that is called as creating a record. Creating a record in the database. Now, after few days, I went to the ATM and I clicked on the mini statement button. Then it is going to give last 10 transactions it is giving. If I want 10,000 transactions, will it give, sir? No. The system is designed in such a way it will be giving only what, sir? 10 transactions. That means you can read the data, but you can read only partially, we can read it. Up to some extent you can read it. Right. That is the reason what I can say is, here it is what, sir? It is a partial reading. Now, after few days, he went and said like, boss, I have $1,000 in my pocket. I want to deposit in my account. Then let us say your total balance is $10,000. Now we are giving $1,000. Then available balance becomes what, sir? 10,000 plus 1,000, 11,000. They are going to update that record. Yes or no? Available balance column, the value from 10,000 to 11,000, they are going to update it. So the system should support here update operation 2. After few days, again I am traveling to the India. As you people knows, in India there is no JP Morgan banks and all, right? So I would like to remove that account. Unnecessarily, why to pay every year? I need to pay some service charge and all. To avoid that service charge and all, so I need to remove that account. For that, I will go and I will apply. Okay, I don't want to maintain account. Please remove my account. Then they are going to inactivate from the customers table. That is called as soft to delete. They are not going to delete the record, sir. They are going to inactivate the record. So that is called as, anyhow, in our words, we can call it as delete. So tell me, if you want to run our business, means these are the four activities what you need to do end of the day. You may be need to create a record. You may be need to create a record. Or you may need to read some record. Or you may need to update record. Or you may need to delete the record. Apart from these four operations, anything else you need to do, sir? Any type of business it may be. You take retail business or banking business or healthcare business, whatever business you take, these are the four operations what you are doing. That much of small world is our software. If you take Java or .NET or PHP, whatever you take, end of the day, they are trying to do what, sir? They are trying to do some data, they are trying to insert into the database. They are trying to read something from database. They are trying to update something in the database. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, if you want to run our business, means these four activities are mandatory activities. These four activities are mandatory activities. Let us move on to the next one, analysis. If you want to analyze your business, how you are going to analyze, sir? How you are going to analyze? Right. Let us say you have $100 available, sir. This $100 you want to invest in the share market. You want to invest in the share market. Then tell me, what is our approach? Directly you'll go and buy some company share, or you are going to analyze it? If analyzing means, what are the activities you are going to do? First, you are going to open our newspaper, whatever it is came to your home. We are going to read what are the comments of the experts. Which share value is going to increase down the line. Those all comments, we'll read it. Those all comments we'll try to justify by using in the Google or somewhere, we'll justify by using comparing by some other experts. This expert's bullet points I am going to compare with, what, sir? Some other expert bullet points. Both are synchronizing. I will get the strength on my decision. Yes or no, sir? Then finally, I will have my own analysis also. I will add my own analysis to that expert's analysis. Then I will try to invest my money. Yes or no?
Yes.
That means what you are doing is to take the decision, lot of things you are reading. Once you read lot of things, then you are going to analyze the things, what is happening, then you are taking the decision. So to analyze your business, I hope you need to do only one activity. That is what, sir? Reading. We are not inserting any record in the database. We are not updating any record in the database. We are not deleting any record in the database. We are only reading data from the database. That's it. We are only reading data from the database. That reading is enough for me to understand or analyze my business. From that analysis, I am going to take decision. Okay, we are very clear for that. So analyzing is nothing but only reading is required. Analysis means what, sir? Only reading is required. That is what we are trying to tell here. One point. That point is. We are going to design OLTP. Automatically it is not coming, sir. We are installing, we are configuring, we are using in such a way it supports what, sir? These four functionalities. We are going to design this OLTP also in such a way it supports only what, sir? Read operations. It supports only read operations. Right. This is the major difference between OLTP and OLAP. It supports these all four functionality supports, whereas it supports only one functionality, that is reading functionality. It is going to support reading functionality. It is going to support. Let us move on to the next one. Fifth point. It is application oriented database, whereas it is subject oriented database. What is the meaning of this one? It is application and subject. Okay, to understand more about that one, I'm going for next sheet. I'm taking one business that is called as, let's say, Google business. I'm taking Google has n number of applications are available, n number of applications are available with him. Yes or no, sir? Some of the applications we take, we have www.youtube.com. Okay, and we have one more thing, let's say www.google.com. And we have one more application that is called as, sir, Gmail. We have one more application, let's say Google Plus. Google Plus. Like this, n number of applications are available. N number of applications are available. And whatever activities you are doing in this application, you may be storing in one database. You may be storing this total data into one application, one database. This is what the database. This database, I am giving the name as, let us say, OLTP1. This may be developed using same data. This may be developed using a software. The software is what, sir? It may be using developed one software that is called as Oracle software. And if you go for next one, this one, let us say I am taking this one, Control C. Right. This is called as OLTP2. This may be developed using same software, or you may be going for what, sir? Different softwares also you may be going because based on the is requirement and all. Based on the is requirement and all. Okay, now we cannot give the guarantee by saying you may be going for the same database or maybe going for different databases. Yes or no, sir? Right. Like this, I have n number of OLTPs are available. So surely remember one point, one database, one application is available means that application corresponding dedicated database compulsory available, sir. So what I would like to say is I have these are the different OLTPs are available now. Now my problem is, let us say I want to design one thing, one subject area. The subject area is called as sales subject area. I am a sales manager, sales manager for entire Google company. So I need to take care of what are the activities are happening in the YouTube, what are the activities are happening in the Google, what are the activities are happening in the Gmail, everything I need to take care. Then I need to send 4 mails to them, one mail to YouTube guys. Please tell me this month's sales, what are happening. In the YouTube, who are placing ads and how much they are paying it. And Google guys also need to send one mail, this month who are placing ads and tell me how much they paid. And Gmail also similar way, and here also similar way. They are going to send the data, but they are going to send the data in different formats. Here name means here available first name, last name, middle name. Here name means it may be available first name and middle name. Here name means it may be available full name. Here name means it may be available surname, first name, last name, middle name. Possible. So different formats it is available. Then that guy will not be happy with this one. Then he's come up with you one thing. Boss, you do one activity, whatever you want to do. From this all things, you develop the things in such a way. You do one activity. That activity is what, sir? ETL activity, you do it. And I want end of the day sales data I want from all these sources. Then we are going to do ETL process. We are going to give input of these all OLTPs to the ETL. And we are going to generate what, sir? We are going to generate one data mart or subject area. This is called as what, sir? Sales is a one subject area. Sales also called as one data mart. Sales also called as one business area. If I call whatever name, these all things are one and same. Sales, business area, or sales data mart, or sales subject area. If you want to see some of the live examples of the subject area, I can show you using my DAC client. I am opening that DAC that also we are going to deliver as part of our course. Let me open that DAC so that we can see some of the examples of the subject areas. Right. Let us say I am trying to log in. So this is called as what, sir? Data Warehouse Administration Console. Data Warehouse Administration Console. Now it's open. Left side, I am seeing the design tab. In the design tab, I have one thing that is called as what, sir? Subject areas. Subject areas. If you go inside the subject areas, there I have, let us say, I have one of the thing that is called as CRM. Sales is the one subject area is available. Under CRM sales, if you go and see what are the tables are available, sir. Invoice table, opportunity table, like this n number of tables are available. Now I hope you people understand what is the meaning of subject area. Sales subject area means what, sir? Sales relevant tables we are going to group under one area. Group under one area. Whatever tables are talking about the sales, directly or indirectly, it's talking about the sales means we are going to group under the sales. These all group of tables which are talking about the sales are called as sales subject area, or it is also known as sales data mart. Sales data mart. Am I clear? Similarly, tomorrow if you want to go for the, let us say, loyalty. Loyalty means what, sir? Giving benefits to the customers. Okay, loyalty means, under loyalty, what are the tables are available, sir? All our loyalty tables are available. So one type of tables, if you group under one thing, then it is called as that subject area. Sales relevant tables, if I am grouping under one area, and we are saying as sales subject area. Loyalty relevant things are grouping under one area, and we are saying as what, sir? Loyalty subject area. Loyalty subject area. How to create the subject areas, down the line you come to understand. As of now, subject area means what, sir? Grouping one type of tables under one area is called as subject area. Okay, that point is very clear. Now, this guy, whatever one subject area is created here, my sales manager, whatever you want, you will get from here only. Yes or no? YouTube related things, or you want Google related things, or you want Gmail related things, everything is available there, sir. Here only it is available. So we are organizing our data warehouse as for what, sir? As for subject areas. You are organizing data warehouse as for the subject area. Suppose tomorrow finance guy came and said, like, boss, I want my finance subject area. Then we are going to create one more subject area here that is called as finance subject area. This is finance subject area. Now, once you created the finance subject area, let us say if you want to integrate these all things under one area, end of the day, that is called as our data warehouse. So inside the data warehouse, we have different things. These all things are called as subject areas. So inside the data warehouse, we are organizing the data. Inside data warehouse, we are organizing data as per subject areas, hence it is called as subject-oriented database. Okay, you people understand this point? For each application, we are maintaining dedicated OLTP. Hence it is called as application-oriented. And all subject areas we are keeping as per the business areas. That is the reason it is called as subject-oriented database. So the way you are organizing the data, based on that one, we are saying it is application-oriented, or we are saying it is subject-oriented, Okay, that point is very clear for us. So why you are calling this as application oriented? Why you are calling this as subject oriented? Now tell me, any company you take, it may be Google, or it may be Pfizer, or it may be Walmart, okay, or it may be KeyBank, or it may be JP Morgan, or it may be any other clients. How many OLTPs will be available? How many OLAPs will be available, sir? OLTPs may be what, sir? N number. How many applications are available? That many OLTPs may be available. At least two things they need to maintain. One is for the CRM. One is for what, sir? ERP. One is for CRM. One is for ERP. At least two things they need to maintain. Now, coming to the data warehouse. How many data warehouses will be there in any client, sir? Only one. Only one. That is the reason data warehouse is also known as EDW. EDW stands for Enterprise Data Warehouse. Enterprise Data Warehouse. And some companies are recently changed their names also. Previously, initially it was called as Data Warehouse Team, sir. Thereafter, people are thinking like, okay, data warehouse means what, sir? Data storage location. That is what the warehouse means. Yes or no, sir? What is the warehouse means? Storage location. Data warehouse means what, sir? Data storage location. Actually, we are not storing the data, sir. We are giving some kind of analytical data we are storing. Analytical data, not the simple data. Transactional data we are not storing. We are storing what, sir? Analytical data we are storing. Based on this analytical state data, we are increasing the business intelligence. That's what we are doing, right? We are trying to increase what, sir? Business intelligence. Where my business is going good, where my business is going bad, why it is going good, why it is going bad, everything I am analyzing, I am giving as analytical data. That's what slowly the companies are renamed their department names as DWBI. Data warehousing and business intelligence. We are not only doing the only data storage, we are also improving what, sir? Business, we are improving it. Business intelligence we are doing here. That's how they renamed it. And slowly they realized it, okay, we are not only doing here business intelligence, we are providing enterprise-wise information we are providing. Directly, ready to eat information we are providing. If I ask a question, I want top 10 customers, then I am giving one report to you. Yes or no, sir? That means, whenever you ask one business question, the corresponding information I am providing to you. So, enterprise-wise means what, sir? HR came and asked one question. Sales manager came and asked one question. Finance manager came and asked one question. Someone is came and asked one question. I am able to answer those all questions. That's what companies are renamed their department names are EIM. EIM stands for what, sir? Enterprise Information Management. So we are not only storing the data, we slowly grown our life cycle and we are changing our names also. Initially we are storing the data, that's where we started our life. Then we improved, we slowly are saying as we are giving the business intelligence. Ready to eat some reports we are providing. Thereafter we are saying, yes, I can provide anything now. I have enough experience. Now we are calling it as EIM. Enterprise Information Management, EIM. Am I clear? So what I would like to say from this all story is, so any company will have only one, what, sir? Data warehouse. That is the reason only we are calling it as EDW also. EDW stands for Enterprise Data Warehouse. Enterprise Data Warehouse. In the enterprise, whatever data you want, it may be HR data or sales data or finance data, entire data I am going to store, what, sir? In single place. That's what called as it is EDW. Okay, I hope you people are clear about the fifth point. You people are clear about the fifth point. Let us move on to the next one, sixth one. It is volatile, it is non-volatile. Why it is called as volatile, why it is called as non-volatile, you need to understand. Okay, why we are maintaining in that way? We are the people who are maintaining, yes or no, sir? Database is not coming by default like that. We are maintaining these properties all are, we are designed like that. Why you are maintaining OLTP as a volatile? Why you are maintaining OLAP as a non-volatile? You need to understand. Tell me, in our CPU, I have two types of memories. One is called as RAM memory. Second is called as hard disk memory. What is the difference between RAM and hard disk, sir? What is the difference between RAM and hard disk? Something is saved on the hard disk, it won't be changing lifelong. Yes or no, sir? Until and unless you are going and you are deleting or you are modifying it, that is okay. But automatically, it is what, sir? It is not going to change whatever is saved on the hard disk. But RAM memory is what, sir? Based on your mouse clicks. If you open the Google website corresponding temporarily it is going to store on the RAM only. If you open, let us say, Facebook correspondingly it is going to store where, sir? On the RAM only. Through RAM only we are getting this one. Yes or no, sir? RAM memory. That is a buffer memory. So, the RAM data keep on changing second to second or not, sir? second to second. But whereas RDS data is what, sir? Once you save it, that is fixed. It is not changing. The reason RAM memory, we are calling it as volatile in nature. Hard disk memory, we are calling it as what, sir? Non-volatile in nature. Simple words, what I want to tell is, something which is changing in nature is called as volatile. Something which is not changing in nature is called as non-volatile. It's called as non-volatile. In my case, OLTP and OLAP, what is changing is here, data is changing in the OLTP, so it is called as OLTP is volatile. Data is not changing here, that is the reason it is called as what, sir? Non-volatile. Let us go and try to take one example. Let us say, this is called as JP Morgan business, let us say. And I have here, one OLTP is available. In OLTP, this is, let us say, transaction table, customer, transaction table of nominal information. I'm transactional table, in that one what's a nominal information. Nominal means that guy details, not the money. I'm going to store his phone number is what, his address is what, okay, and what is the mail ID. This kind of nominal information I'm going to store over here. Suppose I have one column that called as, let us say, customer number is available, and next column is available that is called as customer name is available, and next column is called as, let us say, customer phone number, and next column is available, let us say, customer address. Okay, something is available like this. And let us say here I have one more thing also that is called as effective date also available. These are the columns are available. Customer number is equal to 1. Customer name is equal, let us say, name 1. And customer phone number is equal, let us say, 8374899166. And customer address is equal, let us say, 1000 hooks. Okay. Next CA, next USA. So this is what the address, and effective date is equal, let us say, 01 January and 2002. Okay, now that is what available. This is totally called as OLTP data. This totally is called as what, sir? OLTP data. Now I have here OLAP. Tell me how we are getting data into OLAP, sir? How we used to get the data into OLAP? From the OLTP. Source is what, sir? Source is OLTP only. And tell me, every second we are going to move the data from OLTP to OLAP, or some regular periodical intervals we are going to move it, sir? Periodic interval. That periodic interval maybe depends on the business. You may be moving data every day wise. End of the day, you may be moving the data. Or you may be moving the data every what, sir? Week wise. You may be moving the data every what, sir? Monthly. These are the three possible movements what are available. Most of the projects are going to move data daily, you may be moving, or weekly or monthly. Any one rule you are going to follow based on the business. Even some cases, some of the business areas, I mean to say sales related tables, I may be loading every day. And finance related tables, I may be loading what, sir? Monthly. That kind of rules also available. Okay, something we are following and we are trying to disturb this OLAP periodically. In my case, let us assume like I am moving every month, assume like that. Now, first time whenever I am moving, let us say I am trying to take entire data, whatever available here, I am trying to provide here. I provided entire data. Now, after some moment, what happened is, this guy came to India, that to Amirpet and Hyderabad, and it is India. So he changed his address. Possible or not, sir? It's possible. He changed his address, even he may be changing the phone number also possible. Okay, phone number also may not be working, though he's changing the phone number. And effective date also, the effective date is, let us say, 2008. This is what the effective date he given. Now, after 1 month, you need, there is a change in the record. Yes or no, sir? How the loads will be doing here? The loads will be closely observing what is there in the data warehouse. What is there in the data warehouse? Is it any changes are there in the OLTP or not? I am going to look up. I have one thing that is called as lookup functionality is available. My lookup, what it is going to do is closely is going to observe the data warehouse data. It compare with what, sir? My source data. If any mismatches are there, then only it is going to disturb the data warehouse things. So it's going to observe that one. Whenever it is observed some kind of disturbance here, then yes, some kind of disturbance is there in this record. I need to take care about this one. You need to take care means how you are going to take care. You need to take care means are you going to override the existing record whatever available this one? Are you going to override like this? If you override, what is the problem? We are going to lose what, sir? Historical data. Suddenly I came, whenever we are in USA, let's say we used to use all the credit cards like anything, right? Suppose you have the 15 or 20 lakh, 20 lakh you take in the credit card balance. Then that thing, when where I paid it, those are things, details we don't have, yes or no, sir? So what I would like to say finally is, we are not going to disturb the historical data. We are not going to disturb the historical data. If you should not disturb the historical data means whatever it is coming that we need to maintain as what, sir? One more instance of the record. One more instance of the record. Like this you need to load it. Like this you need to load it. If you want to load like this, if you want to load like this, then here one more problem is came. What is the problem, sir? Tell me customer number in OLTP. Customer number in OLTP is called as primary key or not, sir? Primary key. It is also known as natural key. What is it, sir? Natural, this term is very important. Primary key is also known as natural key. OLTP primary keys are called as natural keys. OLTP primary keys are called as natural keys. Now, okay. As it is a primary key properties are what, sir? It is unique in the nature. It is not null in the nature. It is unique in the nature. It is not null in the nature. If it is a primary key, then will it allow the second time the same record, sir? No. It is going to throw error as unique constraint violation. That is what error it is going to throw it. To stop that kind of error, what you need to do, sir? Whatever customer number it is acting as a primary key, we should not use that as a primary key here. We need to declare that as, we need to define that as what, sir? Normal key, normal column only, not the primary key, normal column only. That is in our hand only or not, sir? The keyword primary key, if I define the create table syntax, then it is going to act as a primary key. Otherwise, it is going to act as what, sir? Normal column. So, here I am going to define here normal column. From this one point, you need to understand OLTP natural keys are primary keys. We are no more. We are going to use in OLAP as what, sir? Primary keys. We cannot use it, first of all. We cannot use it because same record I need to load multiple times in my OLAP. Why? Because I need to maintain historical data. You got my point? And then one more problem is came. Sir, then what is the primary key in the data warehouse? Yes, that is the reason we are going to introduce one more key that is called as ROVID. ROVID stands for row underscore warehouse ID. Row underscore warehouse ID. This is OBIWE terminology, sir. It is OBIWE terminology. If you go and see OBIWE tables, let us say I am opening the database. Yesterday I given some kind of walk-up OBIA, right? In the OBIA, what I said, sir, everything is predefined. Everything is predefined. Starts with the ETL, starts with the database, starts with the reports, starts with the dashboard. Everything is predefined. Here I will show you some predefined database tables. I have here SOPA DW1. SOPA DW1 is given by Oracle guy only. Okay, we have a lot of tables are available. If you want to see the count of tables, select count star from TAB. How many tables are available, sir? 1099 tables are available. This many tables is giving for you. Now let us go and observe one of the table I am observing, your known table, let us say employee table. I will go, sir. What is the table, sir? Employee table. Employee dimension. What is the first column we are seeing here, sir? Row underscore vid. What is that, sir? Row underscore vid is a surrogate key. In general words, it is called as surrogate key. Surrogate key. in Informatica or data stays or ODI, wherever you go to generate this surrogate keys, we have dedicated transformations. Suppose if you go for the Informatica ETL tool, we have the dedicated transformation known as sequence generator transformation. If you go for the ODI, we have the dedicated things that is called as sequence is available. If you want, I can open those things also. Let us say ODI I'm opening. ODI I'm opening. It's trying to open. I'm connecting to the repository. Let us say this is a B102 batch. The version which is going in the ODI is 12C, sir. 12C. C stands for cloud year. Oracle slowly jumping all the things into the C level. That means database is jumping into the Oracle 12C, and slowly all these products is going to jump into the 12 series. Okay, now if you go and see here, I have one thing that is called as, what is available, sir? Sequence. The symbol also C, sir, 1, 2, 3. That means what, sir? The sequence is going to generate here. So what I would like to confirm from this is, wherever you go, any ETL tool of the data warehouse, to maintain surrogate keys, we have the dedicated what, sir? Transformations. Dedicated transformations are available. Okay, that much of important point is surrogate key. Surrogate key is a sequence generated number 101, 102, 103, 104. Like this, keep on, it will be generating it. Wherever you want to start, you can start it, no problem. There is no rule like you need to start with the one only. I can define where to start. I can define where to start and where to end also, I can define if I want. Okay, right. So you people understand one point, the point is called as in data warehouse, surrogate key in our OBAWE is called as what, sir? Rovid. It's called as Rovid. That point is clear. Next point. Sir, I have two records, right? How to identify which record is the latest record, which record is the historical record? How to identify that one? Did you understand my question? Whenever you have the two records, which record is the latest record, which record is the old record? How to identify that one? How to identify, sir? By using date. Okay, by using date. That is good answer. Suppose sometime what I am doing is, sometime I am doing hiding. Now tell me how to identify. Based on Rovid. You cannot say based on Rovid. Why? Because sometimes what I will do is, I will maintain this sequence is what's in my hand only. Yes or no, sir? Sometimes I used to reset the things. Let us say I reset it. Okay, then you cannot go with the based on the vid. And one more problem is, this vid also I will use for the multiple dimension tables. I will use same sequence, I will use it. Then what will happen, sir? 1 to 10 will be assigning for the product table. 11 to 20 is assigning for the employee table. 21 to 30 is assigning for the some time table. So we cannot go based on the row vid. Yes, this is where we need to go and we need to see some examples. Let us go and try to see some examples. Actually, this is given clearly in my one of Informatica slide. That's what I want to take example as Informatica slide. So we have one concept, sir. The concept slowly we come to understand. That is known as slowly changing dimension. That we come to understand slowly later point of time. As of now, observe the records here. The slowly changing dimensions are divided into three types, sir. Type one. This is my source, this is my target, this is my source, this is my target, this is my target. First time whenever you are loading, let us say employee ID is 1001, name is Shan, email is shan@xyz.com. What happened is, let us say this guy Shan is working in a company, that company is known as TCS company. What is the company is working, sir? He's working TCS. TCS is a service based company or product based company, sir? Service based company. So once you join to the TCS, you are going to work for TCS or you are going to work for some other customer? work for some other customer only, right, internally. So he joined to TCS, he is working for a customer that is known as XYZ. That client given one mail ID to him, Now, first time whenever he is loading into the target, he is loading as it is, that he is loading here. Now, second time what happened, this project is completed in 6 months of time. Then he is moving on towards the other customer is moving, that is called as ABC customer. Now, you tell me clearly, the XYZ company guy is still going to keep your mail ID or is going to drop that mail ID, sir? He's going to drop that mail ID. You are no more part of that customer, right? He's going to drop that mail ID. So do you need to maintain really the historical data? Really, it is not required. Yes or no, sir? That is the reason what I am doing is I am trying to override the xyz.com with what, sir? shanabc.co.in. We are overriding it. This is called as, like this, if you override, it is called as what, sir? Type 1. That is called as type 1. But most of the times we won't override it. In very, very rare cases. Very rare cases, 1% or 2% scenarios only we are going to override things. That whatever we are overriding that is really is not useful to analyze your business, we are going to override it. Am I clear? Next. Suppose, let us say type 2 means how it looks like. Type 2, let us say what I am doing is whatever source data is available that I am moving here. This one, whenever you are moving, did you observe or not here? I am maintaining here one separate key I am maintaining. This is called as what, sir? PM underscore primary key. This is nothing but I can say data warehouse primary key. Data warehouse primary key. That is nothing but called as Rubit. That is nothing but called as surrogate key. And also last, if you see one thing that is available, what number I am maintaining, sir? Version number I am maintaining. Based on this version number, I come to understand which is historical record, which is current record. If I go for the next instance of the record, let us say I am going for second instance, what happens, sir? abc.co.in, whenever it is came, we are not overriding the existing record. We are entering what, sir? One more instance we are entering and we are increasing the row width. And also we are saying as previously version number is what, sir? 0. Now version number is what, sir? 1. Based on this one, whatever maximum version is available, that we are going to say as it is a current record, whatever lower version is available, that I can say as a historical data. Now, if you go for the next time he is working for the abc.com company. Previously, it is co.in company. Now, what we are doing is, this version number we are increasing still to 1003. But however, with version, we have some kind of query writing difficulties are there, sir. I change it to companies. I change it to projects, let us say. My version max number is what, sir? 1. He changed, let us say, 10 companies. His version max number is what, sir? 9 or 10. He changed, let us say, 20 projects in the same company. Then what, sir? 20 mail IDs are available. So if I want, let us say, I want one report which contains only current data, sir. Then tell me, write the query. You understand my point, right? For my records, I have what, sir? 3 records are available. Corresponding to my records, 3 records are there. Corresponding to yours, 10 records are there because you changed 10 projects. Corresponding to his, we have the 20 records are available. Out of these 20 plus 10 plus 3, we have 33 records are available. Okay, these 33 records corresponding. Current version corresponding records I want. Write the query for that. Bit difficult or not, sir? It is difficult. That is the reason this version number is not that much of popular. Let us move on to the next one. Next one is what, sir? We are going for flag implementation. Flag implementation, whenever you are loading first time, we are saying as what, sir? Y. Whenever we are going for the next time, previous record we are making as what, sir? N, and current record we are making as what, sir? Y. Whenever we are going for next time, N and Y. Now write the query. Same previous scenario, if I want to write the query, anyone can write it. Yes or no, sir? Select star from so and so table where flag is equal to Y. Very simple query, right? That's what this is very famous in the scenario. However, here also one minus point is there. What is the minus point is? From which date to which date he is active? That's what the question I am asking. That answer is not available here. That is the reason we have one more method. That method is called as beginning date. Next word, sir. Ending date. So beginning date and ending date we are going to write here. Whenever these three records are coming, we are going to write the beginning date and ending date. This is also one of the method to store the type 2 records. So to maintain historical data, to maintain full historical data, we are going for what type of dimension, sir? Slowly changing dimension 2. It's called as, sir? Slowly changing dimension 2. In slowly changing dimension 2, we are going to maintain full history. To maintain full history, how many methods are there, sir? Three methods are there. One is called as version controlling. Second is flag controlling. Third is what, sir? Date controlling. However, famous one in this one is date is the first one. Flag is the second one. Version is the third one. However, flag and date combination, if you are able to maintain, that is very good, sir. Flag and date combination. That means what, sir? Same table, I will maintain the flag as well as date also I will maintain. If you maintain like that, that is excellent. That is excellent. That's what we are implementing actually in our live projects. We'll maintain not only flag, not only date, sir. We'll maintain flag as well as date will be maintaining it. That is very easy, not a big task and all. If you know the ETL tools, basic knowledge, you can do that one. Okay, as a theoretical points, you need to understand this one. Now tell me one point here. That point is, one day I entered one record into the data warehouse. Are you overriding that record, sir? If you override, you are losing what, sir? Historical data, we are losing it. That is the reason we are not going to override. If it is a really data warehouse projects, then most of the times 99.99% we are not going to override the records in the data warehouse. Really any changes are occurred also, we are going to enter what, sir? One more instance of that record we are going to enter. That means whatever data available here, this data is changing or not changing, sir? Data is changing. So can I call this as a volatile? Can I call this as a non-volatile? Yes, this is what our total hard work. So finally, your concluding one point, in OLTP, our requirement is running our business. That means we need to provide freedom to end user or customer, whatever you want to do it. If you want to update phone number, yes, we need to allow him. If you want to update address, yes, we need to allow you. Whereas data warehouse is what, sir? That is under control of not the customer. Customer is not going to use data warehouse directly. Business analysts are going to use it. That is the reason data warehouse for the purpose of business analysis purpose. That is the reason we are going to maintain what, sir? Historical data we are going to maintain. Okay. That point is very clear. Let us move on to the next point. Any questions on this point, sir? It is volatile, it is non-volatile. Can I write like this? Right. Next one. In OLTP, data storage time is fixed. Whereas in OLAP, data storage time is what, sir? Variant. One moment, sir. This is a company call. Okay. We'll try to pick that call later. Now, if people understand one point, the point is it is volatile, it is non-volatile. It is volatile, it is non-volatile. Next one. In OLTP, data storage time is fixed. Whereas in OLAP, data storage time is what, sir? Variant. What is the meaning of this one? Right. So to understand this meaning, let us go for some other example. I am taking one more example here. Let us say my business start date is, let us say, 01, okay, January, okay, 2008, and my business data loads are monthly. My business data load server, sir. Monthly, I used to move the data from OLTP to OLIP. That is what my business requirement. Then, if I go and observe, let us say this is my OLTP. This is my OLTP. This is my OLAP. And I have here, let us say, January month I am taking. Let us say, 1 January month I am taking. I am sorry, guys, that I need to pick the call. There is no other option for me. Let us say, now what I am trying to tell is, let us say I am going and I am observing, let us say 1 January 08, I am observing. 1 January 08, I am observing. In this 1 January 08, if I go and observe here, I have the data or not, sir? I have the data. Data of what, sir? January month data may be available. But here, do I have the data, anything? No. Why? Because just I started my business. I didn't load it even one time also into data warehouse. That is the reason there is nothing is available here. Now, let us move on to the next one that I am going for, next scenario. Let us say I am going for the second month I am going. Then here, what is the data is available, sir? I have here February month data, but I have here, what is the month data, sir? January month data is available here. Okay, right. If I go for next month, let us say March month, then what, sir? March month data is available here. Whereas I have the data here. What is the month, sir? January plus what, sir? February month. We are not going to truncate the data in the data warehouse. On top of that one, we are going to do the incremental loading. That's the reason we have the 2 months of data, that is January plus February month data is available. And if you go for the next one, like this, keep on going, then what will happen, sir? 0 months, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, my historical data keep on increases. Yes or no? My historical data keep on increases. As my historical data keep on increasing, I can say what, sir? I am maintaining the full data warehouse I am maintaining. Yes or no? So the day one beginning of the business, two, we are maintaining it. Even though I am saying theoretically that day one to year it is available, that doesn't mean that it is always, it's true, sir. Suppose let us say one bank is available, SBI Bank, which started in the year of the 1940, like that. Doesn't mean that one I have the data 1940 to today. Okay, business analysis purpose, how much of historical data is really required? That much of data only I will maintain. For my business to analyze, let us say in my current project. Now she is talking about the goal, something she is telling, right? Okay, for my business, we are maintaining only 6 years of the data. 6 years of the data is enough for my customer. So we are maintaining only 6 years of the data we are maintaining. Whenever 1 month extra came, bottom month, 1 month will be deleting, and well, sir, upper month, 1 month will be you are adding. That all depending on the business logics and all, we are going to maintain the historical data, how much historical data we need really. Am I clear what I'm trying to say? Right. So let us move on to the next point here. Here at any point of time, we are maintaining only 1 month of data we are maintaining. At any point of time, we are maintaining what, sir? 1 month of data only we are maintaining. 1 month of data we are maintaining. Here what, sir? Here 0 months, here 1 month, here 2 months, here 3 months, here 4 months, like this keep on increasing. That is the reason, can I say time is varying here? Time range is varying, sir. Your time is what, sir? Fixed. Only 1 month. Here 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, like this happening. Okay, that people understand very clearly. That's what we are saying as in OLTP, data storage time is fixed. In OLAP, data storage time is variant. Next one, OLTP DBs are isolated as for applications. See this diagram. At any point of time, this OLTP and this OLTP communicating, sir? No communication. Separately available means what, sir? Isolated. Separately available means isolated. Okay, that point we understand very clearly. So OLTP DB are isolated as per applications. Next, OLAP is integrated as per subject area. Now, number of users are more here. That is, customers plus employees are available. Number of users are less here, that is middle level management and high level management. What is the meaning of this one? Tell me, Who are the people are using ATM machine, sir? Every employee of the bank using, every customer, each and every customer is using the ATM. Yes or no, sir? ATM application is back end. What database is available, sir? OLTP database is available. Can I say indirectly all employees, all customers are using OLTP or not? Yes. Tell me, who are going to take the business decisions? I want to give car loan. I want to give car loan by paying 10% down payment. Remaining 90% I am going to provide the loan with the interest rate of, let us say, 9% or 9.5% or 10% or 10.5%. Who is going to take this decision? As a customer, you are going to take it? Or as a bank clerk is going to take it? Bank PO is going to take it? No. Bank managers or high-level management going to take that decision. That means, who are going to use the data warehouse, sir? Middle-level managements or high-level managements are using it. Now, if I compare the counts of this one, OLTP users are too much more than the OLAP users. There is reason in the interview also, if you ask one question, how many business users are available? Even in the previous my phone conversation also, she is keep on talking about the business users, business. That's what she is telling, right? So she is a responsible person for the onsite prospective. She is going to communicate with the business users. So most of the times business users will be available 50 to 200, sir. That much only. 50 users towards, sir, 200 users. If you are more than that, it is not available. See here, middle level, high level management means what, sir? Let us take one bank. How many branches are there in the bank, sir? Let us say 100 branches, 200 branches, each branch one manager. So how many members will be there, sir? 200. So what I would like to say is, even all managers are not going to take the decisions also. Okay, some of the high level managers only going to take the decisions. Am I clear or not, sir? So always we can say 50 to 200 users are my application users, you can say. Whatever reports tomorrow you are going to generate, the reports are going to use by 50 or 200 members. That's what your things. That means what I would like to say is OLTP users are too much more than the OLAP users. Let us move on to the next point. OLTP versus OLAP. In OLTP, we'll use normalized schema. Whereas in OLAP, we'll use what, sir? Denormalized schema. In OLAP, we'll use denormalized schema. What is the meaning of that one? Why normalized? Why here denormalized? Why it is normalized? Why it is denormalized? That we need to understand. This point I will cover in tomorrow's class. And we'll go for the rest of the things. Am I clear? This point alone will cover tomorrow's class and we'll go for the rest of the things. Tomorrow, I am slowly entering into your OBAW slides, sir. This slide is coming from the OBAW only. Don't miss tomorrow onwards classes. Very important classes. Am I clear?
Right.
Thank you. And also, I am expecting by tomorrow, I am providing your one hard copy notes I am providing, right? Same time. Tomorrow also same timings. 7 to 8 your batch is as it is. And we are providing one hard copy notes. Anyone have that one? Hard copy notes. Okay, that hard copy notes you should have with you, sir. Okay, that in that hard copy, this is what the notes what I am providing to you people. If you go and see, OBA, classroom notes, this is what is available. This is the same document I am taking the print out, I am making as one book, I am delivering to you people. Whatever I am teaching here, everything is available here. You need not write the notes in the classroom. Any extra points I am telling, that extra point you want to write, it means you can write it. The notes is beautifully designed in the screenshot wise it is designed, sir. You can get this one free of cost in the front office. For online folks, we cannot courier this one. That is a problem. So you need to take the print out of this one. You need to take with your own money. Okay, right. So anyone is available locally? Yes, we are going to provide free of cost only. If you want, you can collect from here. No problem. That is the one option is available. Okay. Here screenshot wise available, sir. You can practice very easily. By tomorrow, my expectation is you should have the notes with you people. That is the one thing. Second thing is whatever materials I am showing here, this is called as Google Drive, sir, actually. I am maintaining these all things, sir. What, sir? Google Drive. They will be providing access to this OBA lab copy. OBA lab copy, they will be providing access. If you provide your Gmail ID in the front office, they are going to provide access to this OBA lab copy. Then you can download entire these things. Inside this OBA lab copy, we have all the things that are available, like must practice, BA publisher, DAC and OBA, Informatica, real-time reports, RITech model CVs, recordings of the classrooms. Okay, this is not there. RITech optional topics, projects with live data, OBA 11G advanced training, these all things are available. So you can provide in the front office, not to me. Provide in the front office, that means rritech@gmail.com, online people you can mail to that one. They are going to provide the access related things. That is the second point. Third point, starts with the installation. Okay, you have your laptops, means give that laptops to admin. Admin is going to do it, or else you can do your own also. Whatever you like, you can do it, and also ready with the installation. Am I clear? Right. These are the three steps what we need to do, action steps today's class. Number one action step is collect the notes. Number two action step is download this lab copy and ready with that one. Number three action step is go with the installation process. Am I clear? These are the three action items. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Yeah. At the 8 to 11, we better. Weekend class people will be having the 8 to 11. Don't eat off.